Hello guys, welcome back to the channel once again, and in this video I'll show you how can you set up your free VPN service over Windows desktop. This is very easy, super easy. All you just have to follow the steps that I'm going to tell you now. Okay, so first, coming to the Google Chrome, let me show you the search result by searching google.com. You can see the search result it is offered within India is with these languages and all. So the VPN service I'm going to introduce you with is called VPN Kid, and this is open service project like public free VPN cloud hosted project offered by Shikibu University in Japan. And if you know about this, it's good, but if you don't, it's okay. So you have to download it's set up. It's super easy. You just have to hit download. You can get the direct link from the description down below as well, and just download this package. You just have to install it, and it is very, very, very easy, like a normal application package has. So just install it. Later that, you have to come to its console. Just open it. It is named as Soft Ether VPN Client Manager. At the beginning, you won't have this virtual network created. You have to create it, or it would ask by itself to create a new one. So just hit double tap over this add VPN connection and go with yes, and just name it with VPN, VPN2 or whatever it is, and just hit OK. It will create a new separate VPN adapter within your network settings. Alright, so the network adapter installation is done. Now we are just going to connect it with some IP address or the domain names. To get that, you just have to double tap over this VPN gate public VPN rely servers. Double tap, you will be able to see some list, and it has different things. Like you can see the host name, IP address, region, uptime, VPN sessions, line speed and all. And you can even see the SSL port support with 443 and all, and UDP support as well, and cumulative transfers, users and all. You can see bunch of details of this thing. So to get to the up-to-date IP address, you just have to click over this refresh list, and it will get you to the up-to-date list of the updated IP address and the host name. For example, if I want to get connected to the latest and the best one, I can determine by looking over this line speed. And let me connect it with just for demonstration purpose, let me connect it with this one, a 126.71 with SoftBank something it is. Let me connect to the VPN server. Okay, so we are done. You can see it is established. You can see the status, it is connected. Now if I go back to the Google Chrome and if I search for something, let's see how cool it is. So you can see the search result was instant. There was no gap. And you can see the search result offered from Japan. And now if I want to download something like Java or something, let me just show you how fast it is. Even over this Wi-Fi connection or over this VPN connection. Okay, so here you can see this is the normal download speed it is showing, and let me connect it with download it with IDM. Okay, so you can see the download speed is also awesome as like normal speed line. There is no compromise, but it depends on factors of different ISPs. So I don't know about your ISP, but it works fine for my internet channel. So here is the result. Okay, so coming to the next thing, let's switch it with different and let's see what is the difference with this one or the other one. So we are now just going to connect it with the Korean. It would be South Korea. Okay, so yeah, here we are. It is connected, again assigned with some A-class IP. We are going to refresh it, and you can see instantly it says South Korea. Alright, so we are here again. Let me test it by downloading the same package or something else. Start download and let's start. Okay, so it's a little bit different from the earlier one. No, it's not. It's same as like the last IP address and it's working fine. There is no compromise in the downloading speed or over the searching speed. You can even check your IP address and details. It's quite fast. It's very good and it's ultimately for free. So you can take advantage of this application and you can search many things you want. But if you look over this about a thing, it's open source. There's no guarantee of protection over this VPN service. So use it at your own risk, and any compromise of your personal data is not covered with this service. Okay, so yeah, I hope you guys enjoyed this video. If it was helpful, like, share and subscribe to the channel, and thanks for watching. I'll see you guys in the next video. Have a great day. Bye bye.